welcome you all, and thank you so, so much for coming out tonight to my just very favorite place in the entire universe. I know that some of you have traveled a bit of a way to be here, and some of you have just waited a long time to be here, maybe even years. I hope that you see it and you feel it. It's so much more than food. Thanks so much for coming. Cheers!
I'm Erin French. After spending years trying to get away from my small hometown of Freedom, Maine, I not only came back to live, I opened a restaurant.
There's a lot of people. They're all outside. Are we ready?
My kitchen family and I had no formal training and no idea what was going to happen. But we trusted that everything we needed was right here. And soon, people were coming from all over the world to visit us. Every week is a new story, new ingredients.
Bottoms up.
Our restaurant's small. We seat about 50 people a night. Because we're only open 4 days a week for 6 months, it's really challenging for people to get in. A few years ago, we came up with a new reservation process. We found out that our post office was reducing its hours. It was kind of this buzz around town of like, what's gonna happen? Are we gonna lose our post office? All we have in Freedom is the post office and the general store. It's like we have two things. So to lose one of two was kind of a big deal. So we made a reservation system that is a little different. You can't make it by phone. You can't make it by email. It's by postcard.
So this is my parents' house right here on the corner with the stone wall. Where we grew up.
I came home to this place twice. Two really devastating moments in my life. One, when I got pregnant with Jane, that wasn't expected, and I was a single mom, and my parents took me in that first time, and then coming home the second time after my divorce.
I went back to the idea of the supper club. I found an old Airstream that needed to be completely gutted and turned it into a mobile kitchen, built tables with my own hands, and that was the way that I was gonna move forward, was this kitchen on wheels, going to farms and going to orchards and greenhouses and making dinner for people. Maybe it was a fried chicken dinner because it was outside, it was a picnic, or you know, maybe we were doing pork chops under an apple orchard with, you know, apples and whatever it was, whatever made sense for that farm.
I'm never following a recipe. I'm always just doing it by feel and by touch and by taste. I'm not a fancy cook, and I'm not a chef. I don't wear no white coat. I didn't go to school.
I cannot make you the best dish in the world. What I'm trying to do is make you feel the best feeling in the world, and there's food involved.
If you're a chef, you're supposed to be making the best dish in the world and getting recognized for this dish you made, but what does it matter if it doesn't, like, make the person who's eating it feel something? It's not just about food. It's about how you care for people, how you take them in, how you make them feel, how you pay attention to every little detail. It's all really important.
Hi. Can we eat this way?
Date night.
This is the best date night ever already, I can tell.
Thank you.
When I dreamt of the Lost Kitchen, I wanted it to feel like you were coming into my home.
All right, beautiful.
This is the way I'd want you to feel. This is the way I want to take care of you.
Are you excited?
Yes, I'm excited.
When people first come in and they've finally got their first glass of wine on the table, it's always fun to surprise them and bring out little treats, and they'll be like, wait a minute. We haven't even started the menu yet.
Hello. Hello.
How are you?
Good, how are you?
I'm just gonna get you started here.
Sure, thank you.
All right, so you have all sorts of little nibbles here.
The first thing that we're gonna give them is a really beautiful snack board with lots of local cheeses and olives and pickles.
There are two different butters. There's a roasted bone marrow and chive butter, and then a bit of smoked butter down there. Quick pickle kohlrabi we made this morning with some fresh local ginger.
Awesome. Thank you so much.
We've made a fresh celery and leek soup with smoked ricotta and fresh Maine crab meat that we tossed in brown butter.
You get a really strong, like, celery flavor, but then you get that sweetness from the crab. That was my favorite. The crab was amazing.
Sorry, I can't cook you food like this.
We're serving oysters fresh from John's River, topped with pickled apples with sweet apple cider and shallots and chives.
too.
Most beautiful woman I've ever met.
Who is it?
Thanks for putting up with me.
I love you.
I don't even know how to eat an oyster. I don't think I've ever had one.
All right, ready?
Cheers.
Yeah, this is probably, I would agree, this is probably the best thing I've had so far in my life.
I still struggle with how in the world did this happen? How did I get here? I still pinch myself.